Welcome to the newest episode of Middle Aged Fat Ass. This week, I want to talk about my drug addiction. I know some of you who are watching this are scratching your heads and you're thinking, drug addiction? I thought this was a blog about weight loss. Well, the drug addiction that I am talking about is my addiction to fast food. And when it came to my weight yo-yoing and eating over the years, fast food was my drug of choice. So yes, you may or may not want to admit to it yourself, but fast food is a drug, and it's a hell of a drug. And it's a drug that is legalized here in the United States. Now, over the years, I was living in denial about my fast food addiction. And back in my younger days when I was married to my ex-husband, and we were living near downtown and I was performing at Embers, I didn't really have time to have a home-cooked meal or stay at home and take the time to fix something healthy because, you know, I was always on the go. I was performing 7 days a week, and I just didn't have the time. So it would be very rare occasions, like holidays or anniversaries or something like that, that I would actually eat at home. But what lured me into eating fast food was the actual, you know, convenience. Everybody wants convenience. Who doesn't want that, right? And convenience was my enabler. It was my enabler for so long that I did not even notice. And it wasn't just convenience that was my enabler, it was the media. Every single day of my life, I would have images of Ronald McDonald shoved in my face, Burger King, and as I got older and fast food becoming more sexier and more palatable to the mainstream media, I would be bombarded by images of Paris Hilton and Kim Kardashian making fast food sexier, and so to speak. And not only was it making fast food sexier, the all of these enabling things were making fast food a part of my everyday life. And they were not only doing it to me, they were doing it to everybody else around me, and yourself included. You may not want to admit it now, but when you look back later and you start eating healthy, you'll see that it's actually kind of true. Now, the difference between fast food and actual drugs is, well, fast food is sneakier about it. Now, do you know that in some university studies, when they subject rats to fast food, their bodies adapt quite well to it. And when they are withdrawing from the fast food and the fatty acids and the sugars and the salts, they show the same characteristics as anyone who is addicted to crack cocaine, heroin, or any other addictive drugs out there. Now, I know if you're going to be looking at my blog, which I know a lot of you are, a lot of you probably look at my blog on Tumblr, I share tips on how to slowly take fast food out of your life. And there's a lot of tips out there that you can use to slowly phase it out. That way you can kick your fast food habit once and for all. Now I want to talk about my progress this week. As some of you know, I have been slowly taking down my intake of foods. The goal for me is to eventually get down to 1,500 calories a day, which I'm slowly doing. But the max I'm reaching on the average is maybe 1,700 calories a day. Now, last Thursday, I kind of went a little apeshit crazy. And I was eating out, hence the reason for this blog. I ate three times on Thursday, January 23rd, and that was the Thursday of last week. And I consumed almost 3,000 calories of supposedly healthy food, which I thought was good for me, and that was not a good thing. Do you know that in Subway, a BLT on flatbread is 920 calories alone? Yeah! And that's a foot long. So, yeah, I was like, holy crap. Yeah, maybe I shouldn't be having foot longs from Subway anytime soon, because I'm like, They say that's healthy, but that's a lot of damn calories right there. Now, I also told you last week that in addition to taking Xantrex 3 in small doses, I've also, this stuff, the Xantrex 3, if you can see that, it's in a little blue bottle. I've been taking 2 a day of these, and in addition to the Xantrex 3, I've been taking these daily women's multivitamins. And I've been feeling a little bit more energetic, so that's a good thing. But I have also added a new thing into the mix of my daily health regimen. This big-ass bottle of burpless fish oil. Now, before I actually invested in this, I was actually doing some online research about burpless fish oil. And fish oil is supposed to be good for your heart. It's supposed to lower your blood pressure and reduce your triglycerides, which is a good thing. And it also helps slow the development of plaque in your arteries. So, this week I'm going to be starting to take 2 a day before I eat something, so I'll let you know how that goes. And if you want more information about the benefits of fish oil, I have included links in the description area. So if you want to check that out, great. And if you want to check out my caloric intake for the week, you can also check out my Tumblr blog. Now, this is the part is, good news is, as you know, I'm steadily keeping my calories down, but I have not lost a pound. So I am still 208 this week, but I'm okay with that. I mean, it's the beginning of a new 7 days when you're seeing this blog. And since I started taking the Xantrex 3, my body is now slowly getting used to the low doses. So I'm actually going to up the dosage of Xantrex 3 to 3 a day instead of 2 a day and see how my body reacts to that. If I experience any side effects, I promise you guys that I will quit. And I'll document it in my next blog. So, anywho, that is my progress for this week. Stay tuned next week as I talk about more stuff. If you want to check out other things on YouTube by me, you could check out my comedy channel. Also, check out my weekly Tumblr blog, Diary of a Middle-Aged Fat Ass in Portland, Oregon. And if you are looking for more healthier eating tips, check out the links that I've included with the video in the description area, right in the crotch. And I will see you guys next week.